Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Retail's Big Show, the National Retail Federation's 100th Annual Convention and Expo. Please welcome NRF Chairman of the Board and Chairman, President, and CEO of Macy's Incorporated, Terry Lundgren.
Thank you very much, and welcome to New York City, the greatest city in the world of retailing and fashion. At least that's what Mayor Bloomberg asked me to mention to you, and I believe him. And welcome to NRF's 100th anniversary and our big show, which is the largest and greatest gathering in our industry. And if you walk just a few blocks east of here, we'll be delighted to welcome you to Macy's Herald Square, the world's largest, and in my opinion, certainly one of the greatest department stores on earth. And if you haven't figured it out yet, be assured that our time at retailing's big show will be filled with many superlatives. My organization, including Macy's and Bloomingdale's, is very well represented here at this conference because this is where we all see and hear the best and most current information that drives our industry, as well as the products and technology which are being developed to support our companies. Being here is an excellent investment of all of our time. This afternoon's session starts in a few minutes with a presentation by Dan Heath on the topic of customer-centric marketing. Now, this is a topic that's near and dear to my heart because being locally and even individually relevant will be the new standard for success for large multi-store companies like mine, and most of yours, I suspect. Beyond this conference, our participation in NRF throughout the year has been productive. The unique proposition of the National Retail Federation is that we represent such a broad range of retail companies, from family-owned single-store retailers to companies with hundreds of stores and hundreds of thousands of employees. Beyond department and specialty stores and direct-to-consumer retailers, our membership includes restaurants, pharmacies. We truly represent a diverse cross-section of retailers, and that's what makes the message to policymakers in Washington, D.C. so powerful. The retail and restaurant industries represent 1 in 5 jobs in America. So that if there's going to be any kind of job recovery in this nation, it's likely to be that the NRF will play a major role and be a major participant. Now, not many associations can make that claim. So here's my request of all of you. It includes 3 quick items, so please just take a second and write them down or memorize them. One is, make the most of your time here that you'll spend over the next 4 days in sessions and in our exhibit hall, soaking up information that is both relevant and actionable for your business. Because the ideas and the products, they're all here. So just take the time and you'll discover them. Secondly, ask how you can get involved in the many NRF committees, task force, and work groups that touch nearly every aspect of your business. And third, if you're a company that isn't already a member or very involved in NRF, you're missing out on a big opportunity. Our collective voice is so much more powerful than any of our individual voices, and the NRF's voice will definitely be heard in 2011. So it's time for you to join us. Thank you again for being here. Enjoy Retail's big show, and we look forward to seeing you at Macy's and Bloomingdale's and all the great retail stores here in our great city. And happy 100th anniversary to the National Retail Federation. Enjoy the conference.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to